Almost 200 years later, in 61 AD, another great stand by an underdog force occurred. Following the recent conquest of Britain by the Romans, the Britons united under Queen Boudica and decided to overthrow the Romans. Back then, simply waiting for reinforcements to arrive from Rome was not really an option. The Roman governor of Britain was a man called Gaius Paulinus. And so what did Gaius do? He took his only two legions, numbering around 10,000 men, and did what Romans were best at: outmaneuvering and outfighting anything the enemy could throw at them. Paulinus chose the field of battle strategically, a narrow field that was flanked on either side by dense forest. The battlefield essentially acted as a giant funnel of death for the raging British warriors. Boudica's forces numbered around 230,000, although this also included many women and children that made up the supply wagon train that trailed the actual army. The Romans, however, used this to their advantage. With a giant, unruly wagon trail behind them, the British forces were effectively pinned in a narrow chokepoint against the infamous Roman shield wall. As if that wasn't enough, Boudica's troops were very lightly armored. Paulinus took full advantage of this and used his rear ranks to pump them full of javelins, known as pila. Those British troops that managed to avoid being impaled then had to wait in line to be butchered by the Romans due to the narrow chokepoint. The Romans also made sure to cycle the legionaries in the front line after every other wave of Britons to prevent fatigue and ensure that the Britons were always facing fresh troops. When the overconfident Britons finally realized their folly and attempted to retreat, they found themselves penned in by their own wagon trail. With nowhere to run, they had no choice but to try and fight against the slowly encroaching and completely impenetrable Roman shield wall. Roman historian Tacitus claimed that only 400 Romans fell, whilst over 80,000 Britons died, including Queen Boudica, who supposedly poisoned herself. The Romans dealt a crushing blow to the rebellion, killing all the women, children, and even pack animals the rebels had brought to the battle. This victory ensured Roman control over southern Britain, whilst the north remained a volatile region.